is here. She is of Forza's support, capable of dealing some respectable damage, though can be a bit inconsistent in her performance. In the following analysis, we'll examine how she works, how to build her, and look at what team comp she's good in, as well as her expected contribution compared to Verena. Let's get into it. Yohu's kit revolves around her lucky draw mechanic. A lucky draw enhances the next basic attack, and can be gained in the following ways. After casting her skill, Liberation, Intro, Dodge Counter, and Frostfall. This draws one of four random auspices, which have varying effects that you really don't need to think too much about. Instead, what's important is how many of them match. After appraising four lucky draws, you'll be able to cast her forte, Poetic Essence, which does respectable damage, greatly increased based on the auspices you drew. Note that a two pair actually does not increase damage at all, but rather gives a healing effect, so this should be avoided unless you actually need the heal. So this is just an RNG character, right? Yes, but unlike Echo Substats, you can actually manipulate these outcomes to your favor. Her Liberation has a quick time event that allows you to select an auspice to draw. As such, you'll want to always use this to generate your fourth and final auspice if possible. This means that you can guarantee the 70% damage bonus, while being able to get the 175% damage bonus 62.5% of the time. What about Yohu's supportive capabilities? Her skill on cast heals between 2-3 times of a Verena Forte proc, with a potential bonus on hitting a 2-pair or 4 of a kind. She has no inherent team buffs in her kit, outside of her outro, which has the niche effect of boosting coordinated attack damage with a massive 100% amplify for the incoming resonator. This means that her best pairings are characters like JoJo, Yinlin, or Mortify, who deal a majority of their damage through coordinated attacks. We'll discuss her team comps more in a later section. Let's look at how to effectively build her outro. If starting with an intro, you will follow up with her antique appraisal, canceling that with her skill, and following up with another appraisal. During the appraisal animation, hold down your basic attack button to use fortune rolling, stacking up your forte meter. When this fills up, let go to use frostfall, giving you another appraisal. Cancel this appraisal with her liberation, and pick the auspice that will give you the most copies of a single one. Do one final appraisal and follow up with Poetic Essence, and swap out to your coordinated attacker right after. If you don't have an intro to start with, use her skill first instead. You will need to do one more fortune rolling into Frostfall segment to get your fourth draw. You will also need to do one basic attack, as the combo will only yield 99.6 concerto. But if you're using Abyss Surges, you should be using a single basic attack to precede the rotation anyway for the skill damage buff. Because of how you can buffer her fortune rolling during her appraisals, this dilutes the gain from quick swapping with Yohu. However, the field time needed to generate her forte in this way is quite slow, clocking in at nearly 8 seconds. As such, it may not be worth generating her full outro with each rotation. We'll dive into this more deeply later. This wraps up our kit. Let's talk about builds next. As Yohu is a support, you'll want to run Rejuvenating Glow, as her damage is not high enough to justify running a DPS set in a standard setup. Fallacy of No Return can be used over Bell for a more offensive setup, but both are viable. Her damage contribution is not negligible, so it's still worth building her Echoes for damage, especially because her healing scales off attack. 4-3-3-1-1 is the preferred build, with crit rate or crit damage on 4 cost and glacial percent on the 3 cost. Yes, even with her hardest hitting skill having up to a 175% damage bonus that's additive with glacial percent, it's still the best in slot set due to her other damage sources also being relevant. And she won't have that much damage bonus as a base due to running Rejuvenating Glow. In terms of substats, crit is, as always, the highest priority. Skill bonus and attack come very close, with flat attack and even liberation being options afterward. If you're surprised by why liberation is even more than a sliver here, this isn't a double liberation rotation. Energy regen requirements will also vary, ranging from about 5-20% in a double liberation rotation or 0% in a standard rotation. For skill leveling order, her resonance skill has the highest priority, as this not only increases her healing, but also the damage dealt from each of the appraisals, which are a majority of her damage. Next is her forte, her biggest burst damage. The priorities after that are much lower, which include her resonance liberation, intro, and finally basic attack. What about her weapon? Shenlingyao's weapon, Verity's Handle, is technically the strongest, by virtue of being a 5-star limited. However, the gap between it and the standard 5-star Abyss Surges is smaller than that for Shenlingyao, as she doesn't benefit from Verity Handle's liberation bonus, but she does benefit decently from Abyss Surges. Despite being a support, Mercado is not that useful on her, as the concerto gain from it doesn't actually make the rotation faster at all. If you don't get all 4 auspices and use her forte, you're not getting 100 concerto anyway, even with R5. Stonard is a better 4-star option, because at least you get some damage out of it. And next, we'll talk about team comps and how she performs compared to Verena. Here are various teams that feature a coordinated attack sub or dual DPS, alongside the expected DPS with Verena versus Youhu. The first comp, Jinchi Jeje, is one that you'd think she would work well in. However, the real star of this comp is Jinchi, and Youhu doesn't help her stack generation at all, with Jeje's liberation covering most of the uptime for Glacial Incandescence procs. In contrast, she works quite well in the Jeje Sanhua comp, nearly matching Verena's performance at S0, and closing the gap further at S6. She is also fairly competitive in both the Shenlingyao Yinlin team as well as the Jian Mortify team. Note that all of these rotations, except the Jeje Sanhua one, build her outro once every other rotation, sacrificing her buff uptime to give more focus to the rest of the team. Let's quickly go over her sequences, calculating in a team with Shenlingyao and Yinlin. Her S2 is her first major damage sequence, doubling the bonus she receives on her forte. But remember, while this is her hardest hitting skill, it's not her primary damage source. She gains another chunk of damage at S3, and a massive RNG utility at S4, with a chance for her skill to not go on cooldown. Her S5 actually has no value in this example, as it's a DPS loss to give her an intro over Yinlin. Her S6, however, is worth another good chunk of damage. Notice that all of her sequences only benefit her personal damage. This is why they don't make that much of a difference in the overall team DPS. So, is Yoku worth it? While she's not particularly strong in her niche, she makes a decent substitute for Barina in select team comps. And who can say no to this cute blue brat? Her sequences, in the grand scheme of things, are not worth it at all. However, if you do want to do some funny solo DPS Yoku shenanigans, more power to you! I think she's honestly extremely fun to play due to the reactive aspect of RNG, especially after S1 and S4. That's all for this analysis. I'll see you guys shortly for a follow-up where I dive into specific rotations in different team comps. I wanted to push this video out early with the trial footage before I inevitably dump Pulse and not get her. But let's live without a little bit of gambling. See you guys next time. Bye bye.